Men versus women. It's a rivalry for the ages, and in season 6, it played out on our TV screens. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffed, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be stripping down to discuss the winner of Survivor, the Amazon, Jenna Morasca. A 21-year-old swimsuit model from Bridgeville, Pennsylvania, we were first introduced to Jenna Morasca as a member of the Jabiru tribe alongside a 24-year-old adventure guide, Christy Smith, Dina Bennett, a deputy district attorney from California, and Heidi Strobel, a gym teacher from Jefferson City, Missouri. The two tribes were divided among men and women, and the men on Tumbukui were cocky, thinking they could run the board and eliminate all of the women. Jenna disagreed with this though, saying she disliked their cockiness and wanted to shut them up by showing they could hold their own, and they did so early on, winning the first immunity challenge.
They're so freaking cocky. They're like, oh, we're never going to go to tribal council. And it's just so annoying. I just want to beat them to just kind of like shut them up.
Jenna was disappointed that she had to compete against women though, as she recognized that had she been with some of the men, she would have been able to use her womanly powers and charm to flirt with them and further her position in the game. Something that wasn't possible on Jabiru.
Stranded in the jungle with 7 other women is my worst nightmare. If you're on a tribe with all women, you can't use any of your womanly powers on women. They could care less. They find that insulting. With men, it's just you can manipulate them better.
Jenna was well received among her female tribe mates. However, Christy felt that she was being excluded and claims that Jenna hadn't spoken to her across the first 5 days. This makes Jenna appear to be a mean girl and sets up a rivalry that will last the duration of the season. Jenna received a lone vote from Christy at tribal council, but the tribe formed a coalition to eliminate Jenna in a 5-1-1-1 vote. At this point, Jenna, Heidi, and Shauna began to be isolated from the rest of the tribe as they were perceived as being young divas who refused to assimilate with the older women. As Shauna began to show weakness, it became apparent she would be the next to go home on Jabiru. However, Jenna was able to reconcile her differences with Christy somewhat, rallying her to save Shauna and eliminate Joanna. On day 13, the youngest members of each tribe were asked to head to a secret location. Of course, with Jenna being the youngest on Jabiru, she joined Dave Johnson for a summit where the pair enjoyed a nice meal and some drinks, and Jenna perhaps foolishly spilled the beans of the happenings of the Jabiru tribe.
Jenna did go into great detail about the status of her tribe. However, you gotta think, do you want to be revealing all this about your tribe?
Jeff Probst revealed that they would take turns of picking members for their new tribes, and much to Jenna's disgust, Dave stole her closest ally, Heidi. Jenna kept her other allies, Dina and Shauna, while also taking Rob, Alex, and Matthew to join the new Jabiru. Jenna began to bond with her new tribe mates while Shauna and Alex grew extremely close. This worried Jenna and the rest of the tribe, so they plotted to eliminate Shauna, weakening the women's numbers. By day 19, Jenna had formed an alliance with Alex and Rob. When everyone was told to drop their buffs, she was reunited with Heidi on the Jacare tribe, and at the individual immunity challenge, she dropped more than just her buff, stripping it all down for chocolate and peanut butter.
I take my clothes off for chocolate and peanut butter.
Get the girls some chocolate and peanut butter probes.
If you have coal, I'm so in.
Oh, dude, there you go.
Okay, Jenna, Heidi.
Wow, he produces.
Damn.
2 ice cold colas. 1 heaping plate of rich peanut butter.
Okay.
Guys can share. Big tray. Chocolate cookies.
Heidi, you want to do it?
Yeah.
All right.
At this point, Jenna convinced Dina to eliminate Roger, explaining that he would be a bitter juror and not vote for a woman if one of them got to the end.
We are definitely the original Survivor Girls Gone Wild. There's no doubt about it.
We are the Amazon chicks.
Gee, and,
so,
and the,
really,
what makes it even more funny is the guys think that they're slowly picking us off.
Yes, yes.
Which is so, and they're being so nice to me and Heidi. They're like, you know what? You're going to go eventually. And we're like, oh,
we'll try to spare you. Yeah. We'll try to spare you guys.
And we're like, you guys are so sweet. Yeah. Especially with Roger. I mean, he thinks that he's just got it in the bag.
Jenna would go on to win individual immunity, sending Dave home for being a physical threat. At the next reward challenge, Alex won and decided to take Jenna on the reward with him, showing her ability to develop strong relationships. When they returned to camp, though, Heidi revealed to Jenna that Dina was plotting to eliminate Alex, and Jenna used this as information to send Dina home, turning on her former ally. She had affirmed her intentions of going to the final 3 with Alex and Heidi, targeting Matthew, but Alex was blindsided, putting her on the bottom of the tribe with 6 left in the game. She will keep hope alive by winning individual immunity. However, sensing that Heidi was the target, she completely flipped the script by making the bold move of giving individual immunity to Heidi and then joining Matthew and Rob in voting out Christy, despite drawing 2 votes from Butch and Christy. Jenna and Heidi were still outgunned, and Rob made sure that she knew she would be the next to go. This caused Jenna to break down and consider quitting, weighed down by the fact that her mother was unwell back home battling cancer. Despite this, she hung in there and remained strong, reaching the final four where she will win back-to-back immunity challenges and promised a final 2 with Matthew. Rob offered Jenna free passage to the end in the final immunity challenge, and while she wanted to take the strongest to the end, she remained loyal to Matthew's deal and voted out Rob for being the biggest strategic threat, even though she felt that she could have beaten him for the $1 million. On day 39, Jenna arrived at the final tribal council and was criticised for her lack of work ethic around camp and for wanting to quit just days earlier. She fought back, though, by suggesting that Matthew was a tag-along and that she had to work hard to reach the end. This was true, as she played a major role in eliminating Roger, Dina and Christy to cement her place in the end game. By winning 4 individual immunity challenges, she tied Kelly Wigglesworth for winning the most as a female contestant, beaten only by Colby Donaldson in the Australian Outback. When the final vote came in, it was apparent that her strong social relationships helped her to get to the end, winning in a 6-1 vote and becoming the youngest ever sole survivor.
The winner of Survivor Amazon.
Jenna Morasca played a social and strategic game from day one, forming lasting bonds and even managing to work with her strongest adversaries in the game in order to further herself. She dominated physically and was well liked by the jury, not pissing anyone off, and also in the process becoming the first survivor to win by a margin of 5 votes. What did you think of Jenna Morasca's journey to the title of sole survivor? Let us know in the comment section down below. If you enjoy what you've seen, I'd really appreciate it if you give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. New videos just like this one every Tuesday and Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Wednesday and Friday Australian Time. Stay tuned next week as we delve into the story of Sandra Diaz-Twine, winner of Survivor Pearl Islands. Boys will be boys and girls will be girls. In the game of Survivor, you have to do anything to get yourself further in the game, even if it means stripping down for chocolate and peanut butter. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
Oh God, why me? Why did I die? I'm not looking.
Nope.
I gotta stay focused.
Where can I keep my clothes?
I'm looking.
Hey, just pull your pants down to your ankle.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I'm not looking.
1, 2, 3.
Oh my God.
Ta-da!
All the kids at school, I'm not looking.
Okay. Nobody's looking. You guys aren't even trying to tempt these guys off with this.
I'm looking. Are you kidding me?
Maggie, you wanna jump in?
Yep.
All right, let's go.
Hold on, I gotta get my shorts. Are they around your ankles?
I've been to drink.